What's up, everybody? Welcome to A New English Bit. I'm Katia, and in today's lesson, we're going to learn 10 advanced nouns that will help you expand your vocabulary and excel in your CAE and CPE exams. Are you ready? So take a notebook and let's kick off. So first, we're going to learn 5 C1 nouns, and in the second part of this video, we're going to look at 5 C2 nouns. So the first noun we're going to learn today is actually double, as we have two nouns that mean exactly the same and have the same level. And they are downside and drawback. Pronunciation long O, draw, drawback, American or British drawback. And they mean disadvantage. So in the exam, instead of using disadvantage, you can say drawback or downside, which are more advanced. And now let's look at 3 examples. The first one of the drawbacks of living in the city is the air and noise pollution. The second example, electric cars are eco-friendly. The only downside is that they are still very expensive. And one more example, he really likes his job. There aren't any drawbacks for now. Let's move on to our second noun, which is outlook. It has 2 meanings. The first one is a person's attitude to life and the world. For example, I like her positive outlook on life. And the preposition we would use in this case is on life. And the second meaning of outlook is the likely future situation. For example, the outlook for reducing social inequality is bleak. Bleak is an interesting adjective, level C2, which means with little or no hope for the future. And the preposition here is the outlook for something. And one more example, the outlook for the weekend is sunny and dry, which means that the weather is likely to be very good this weekend. Let's continue. Our noun number 3 is scope. Scope. It also has 2 meanings. The first one is the range of things covered by a book, activity, discussion, class, etc. For example, I find his idea limited in scope. And another example, I was disappointed when I found out that this content was outside the scope of the course. And the second meaning of scope is the opportunity for doing something new. For example, nowadays, there is a lot of scope for making money online. In this case, the preposition is for. Scope for. Let's move on to our noun number 4, turnover. It also has 2 meanings. The first one is the amount of goods and services sold by a company in a period of time. For example, the company has an annual turnover of $500,000. And the second meaning of turnover is the rate at which employees leave a company. For example, the manager is worried about a high turnover of staff. And another example, the turnover at this organization is so rapid that no one stays more than a year. Let's continue. Number 5, endeavor. Endeavor. It's a formal noun, which means an attempt to do something new or difficult. It's spelled with U if it's British, and without you in American English. The first one, reaching the summit of Mount Everest, is an outstanding example of human endeavor. Another example, in spite of our endeavors, we couldn't meet the deadline. And one more example, I made a huge endeavor to finish the marathon last May. If you haven't seen the video on my first marathon in Copenhagen, you can do it by clicking on the card right here. And before we continue with our C2 nouns, a quick reminder to subscribe to English Bits by clicking on this red button so that you don't miss new English lessons with me. And now let's start with our C2 nouns. Number 6, train of thought. Train of thought. Pronunciation, long O. Thought. And it means a series of connecting thoughts that someone's having. Collocations that we can use with this noun are to lose your train of thought, to break somebody's train of thought, or to follow somebody's train of thought. And now let's look at 3 examples. The first one, I couldn't follow his train of thought as his speech was rather incoherent. The second example, the phone ringing broke or interrupted my train of thought. And the third example, I've lost my train of thought. What was I saying? In Spanish, it would be se me ha ido. Let's continue. Number 7 is crackdown. Crackdown. The British pronunciation crack. Crackdown. In one of the previous English bits, we learned the phrasal verb to crack down on something. In this case, it's a noun, crackdown, and it means a strong action to prevent a particular activity by someone in authority. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, there has been a series of crackdowns on drink driving. The second example, the government is launching a new crackdown against smuggling. And the third example, the police is calling for a crackdown on fly tipping. Fly tipping means illegally leaving rubbish in public places. Let's move on to our noun number 8, consensus. Consensus. It means an agreement or decision among a group of people. Let's look at some examples. The first one, let's try to reach a consensus on this issue. The second example, the general consensus of the board of directors was to put off the project. And one more example, there is a growing consensus on banning traffic in the city center. Our second to last noun is quest. Quest. It means a long search for something that is difficult to find or an attempt to achieve something difficult. Some collocations with this noun, for example, the quest for knowledge, happiness, or truth. Some examples, the first one, she's going to Bali on a spiritual quest. The second example, they want to travel the world in quest of adventure and lifelong experiences. And one more example, he meditates daily in his quest to build up a more peaceful mind. And last but not least, the noun trait. Trait. It means a particular quality in someone's personality. Now let's look at 3 examples. The first one, positivity, is one of my mom's best traits. Another example, my brother's main personality trait is his sense of humor. And the last example, a character trait that should never be lost, is curiosity. So guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this English bit and found it useful. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and like this video, as it means a lot to me. Also, remember to follow me on Instagram, where you can find a daily quiz. And if you liked this English bit, make sure you watch these 2 videos on advanced adjectives and verbs. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!